Want to adjust the finish of your 3D text within Final Cut Pro? Simple, couple clicks away, come on over.
If you haven't already, be sure to check out our video covering the basic substance controls. In this video, we'll be taking a look at how to use the finish controls. Let's start by applying a finish layer. We could add a layer of polish that sets the reflectivity and glossiness. Enamel has the same options but allows us to choose a highlight color. Brushed and textured both let us choose specific patterns, like combed or knockdown. And we can also adjust the depth of the textures. Down here, there is a reverse depth checkbox in case we want to invert the texture.
It looks pretty good so far, but let's keep going.
Next, let's explore the distress layer options. We can use this to create wear and tear on the surface of our 3D text. There are several options here, and all of them are pretty self-explanatory. We can choose stains and browse the different types in the menu. Same with wrinkles. There are many great presets built into Final Cut Pro. Let us know what your favorites are in the comments below.
And we're not done yet. One more thing.
Next, we'll explore the emit controls. But first, we'll change the material to ice block. Then, we'll select the Add Layer dropdown and choose Emit. The emit layer causes the 3D text to self-illuminate, or glow. Let's see how we can adjust the effect. We can choose the light to be based off of a color or a gradient. The intensity slider allows us to adjust the strength of the light emitted. And coverage adjusts how visible the emit layer is, based on the materials below it.
And that covers everything you need to know about finish controls on your 3D text in Final Cut Pro.
Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you enjoyed this episode, please share, like, and tell your friends.